Hi, everybody. Welcome to Coffee and Campsites. On today's episode, we're visiting Yosemite National Park. So grab a cup of coffee and let's go camping. Yosemite National Park. Easily one of the most iconic and special places in the American West. Towering granite rock spires and domes, 3,000-foot sheer walls, and spectacular waterfalls abound here in Yosemite Valley. The protected forest is 748,000 acres of pristine wilderness, enticing travelers from all over the world to hike, bike, climb, and even float through its splendor. President Abraham Lincoln signed the Yosemite Land Grant in 1864. This was the first time the federal government intervened to protect and conserve the country's own natural landscape. 8 years before Yellowstone became the world's first national park. This great forethought led to the preservation of Yosemite Falls, El Capitan, and of course, Half Dome, the behemoth rock face that extends 4,700 feet above the valley floor, calling on hikers to ascend the cables to its summit.
Yosemite is by far the grandest of all special temples of nature I was ever permitted to enter. John Muir.
A truly inspiring statement from one of the most important figures in the safeguarding of the Yosemite wilderness. Imagine if every traveler approached the outdoors as a humble guest. Centralized in California's Sierra Nevadas, shrouded in coniferous forest, only 3.5 hours from San Francisco and a manageable 5.5 hours from Los Angeles, Yosemite Valley is an 8-mile-long glacial valley carved out during the ice ages, a transformation that began 50 million years ago. It was this transformation that yielded the breathtaking waterfalls and granite rock formations travelers see today. The combination of which attracts millions of visitors. Today, the park sees an average of 4.5 million guests a year. For trail maps, goods and services, bike and raft rentals, and more, visitors can go to Curry Village. This is the largest lodging area in Yosemite, with tent cabins, wood-sided cabins with private or shared bathrooms, and motel rooms. Other amenities include, but are not limited to, a swimming pool, ice rink, pizza deck, and ice cream stand. The Yosemite Visitor Center, Post Office, and Ansel Adams Gallery are located on the west side of the valley at Yosemite Village. Visitors can explore the Yosemite Museum and learn about the Ahwahnee people, who called this land their home for over 7,000 years. The Yosemite Cemetery is an easy walk and holds the history to some of Yosemite's most valued residents, some of which knew no other home. Lucy Brown. Easy day hikes around the valley floor include Lower Yosemite Falls, Mirror Lake Loop, and Cook's Meadow Loop. It's genuinely difficult to put the camera down with so many iconic views around every corner. For travelers wishing to put some miles under their boots, Yosemite Wilderness has 750 miles of hiking trails. Popular day hikes from the valley floor include Upper Yosemite Falls, Nevada Falls, Half Dome, and Glacier Point. All are very strenuous hikes. With the exception of Nevada Falls, all have an elevation gain over 3,000 feet. This is Nevada Falls via the Mist Trail. The trail is close to 8 miles long, elevation gain is nearly 2,000 feet, and hikers get a very close look at Vernal Falls as well. Bring a rain jacket or poncho, you're going to get wet. For the more adventurous outdoor enthusiast, rock climbing in Yosemite Valley reigns supreme. For nearly 60 years, these giant granite formations have been the aim of climbers wishing to challenge themselves in spite of great personal risk. Some visitors prefer a leisurely float down the Merced River. Boats may be put in or taken out at either Stoneman Bridge or Sentinel Beach, but nowhere in between. For other boating and swimming regulations, please see nps.gov as these rules may change with water levels and seasons.
That's so cool.
Mule deer are very common in and around campgrounds. If your timing is just right, you may cross paths with a bobcat.
Dude, you guys are pros. We were just talking about how many millions of bobcats are in the U.S. and we've never seen one.
And if you're lucky, you may see a black bear grazing in El Capitan Meadow. With 165 resident avian species in the park, there's no shortage of bird watching as well. Remember, always keep a safe and respectable distance while viewing wildlife. Mountain dogwoods yield flowers of white along the Merced River. Pretty pink dogwoods blooming accent Cook's Meadow. And pine, hemlock, fir, and sequoia trees make up the lush forest here in Yosemite. Wildflowers include, but are not limited to, the spider lupine, tufted poppy, and Applegate's paintbrush. With all the amazing granite features, abundant wildlife, and towering trees, it's easy to get lost in the beauty of Yosemite National Park. For base camp, we booked our stay at Upper Pines Campground in Yosemite Valley. This is a large campground with 235 sites, accommodating both tents and RVs. Each site has fire pits, picnic tables, and bear boxes. There are flush toilets and drinking water centrally located to each loop, and as a whole, it is a very convenient location to make all of your day trips out of. In all honesty, if you're able to book a week in Yosemite Valley, be it North Pines, Lower Pines, Upper Pines, or even Camp 4, it would be wise to do so. Yosemite Valley is very difficult to get more than two consecutive nights. Yosemite National Park remains one of the greatest examples of American conservation. We never take these visits for granted, and we consider ourselves lucky to have seen so many of the wonderful monuments here. Thank you for enjoying the outdoors with us. If you've enjoyed our video, please like and subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching. Coffee and Campsites.